Hey guys, how's it going? In the last makeup haul I did, I showed this Maybelline eyeliner, and I think I'm going to do a first impressions of it because I've never used this gel eyeliner before. I'm going to do each eye with a different eyeliner brush. I'm going to do one with the brush that they give you in the kit, and one with my MAC normal eyeliner brush. It's the MAC 210 brush. Eyeliner brush, I'll compare the brushes first. So, this is the MAC one, this is the Maybelline one. Handle wise, I think I actually prefer the Maybelline one. It's sort of like easier to hold on to. This is the first time I've used this brush. It's sort of like flat, like that if you can see, it's sort of like flat and thin. Whereas this one's more rounded. So both good, I suppose, for different eyeliner jobbies. I can't open it. This is the most difficult part so far, is trying to actually open the product. Oh my god, this is legit impossible. Oh, there we go. Okay, so that's what it looks like in the pot. Black gel eyeliner, pretty regular looking. Okay, so I'm going to try, I think I might use my MAC brush first. I just dunked it in some water. I always kind of wet my brush first, and then just kind of like, yeah. Just a little bit, it doesn't need to be super saturated or anything, just enough to give it some moisture. I feel like that helps. I don't know why. We'll just pretend like it does. Okay, so far the consistency is pretty good. It's quite, it's got a bit of resistance to it. It's not like really gloopy or anything, which I prefer. As I'm putting this brush in here, I tend to do this because I do, because of the shape of my eye, I do quite a thin line, so it helps to flatten the brush out. So this is my MAC one. As you can see, I've flattened it out just by going like this with the product, kind of like on either side of the brush, like that. So here we go. So you guys can see. Okay, so that's the MAC brush side done. It's pretty good. I feel like it's definitely not, if I'm to compare this to the MAC, this one here, it's just black track, fluid line, MAC standard eyeliner gel stuff. This is definitely, I think, thicker on the eye. This is, like I said, this has got some resistance to it when you put it on the brush, which kind of in my mind made me thought that it was going to be a bit thicker on and therefore be a bit more opaque. I'll wait for it to dry before I fully, you know, commit to that opinion. It's not bad. I think this is probably good if you're like a beginner and, you know, if you screw it up a little bit, it's not going to be as difficult to correct, I think. This one's kind of more like bulletproof. So now I will try this brush, and I'm going to get this wet just a little bit. Sort of freshen the brush up a little bit. And then we'll dip that in there. And do the other eye. Don't need to fight to prove I'm right. Okay, yeah, so that definitely, it comes out a lot sheerer with this brush. I'm gonna like put some more on. Okay, so I'll try and close up of both of my eyeballs now, so you can see. Okay, so in terms of the product itself, I definitely don't think it's as substantial, opaque, and I mean, I only just put this on, so I can't tell, but I've got the feeling it's probably gonna rub off a little easier than, let's say, Black Track by MAC. But I mean, this is like less than half of what this is. This is probably about a third of the price. I think the prices are probably pretty universal. In New Zealand, Oh, I can't remember. I think this was probably about $50. This was about 16, I think. So that's obviously a bonus with this one. I feel like you could build it up to be more opaque. And I wouldn't necessarily not have the patience for that. I would be able to do that, but that therein lies, the problem of if you make a mistake on one layer, it's like, like I just want to do it in one fell swoop and have it good and clean. So I think next time I'm in a MAC store, I probably will pick some more of this up just because this one's running out. It's like getting pretty dire. So I thought I just wanted to pick up a one I could use in the in-between. And I will use it. I think another way to probably make this more opaque, but again, brings in the problem of you probably won't get the crisp line if I did this. Using a black eyeshadow kind of to set it. So I think if I was going to do that, I would use my MAC brush to apply the eyeliner, and then maybe this thinner one. This does have good precision, but for whatever reason, I'm not a makeup artist. For whatever reason, it seems to sheer out. I think because this brush is denser than this one shears out the product a little bit more, and this one applies it a little more opaque, which is kind of what I want, especially when the product itself is a little, on the sparse side, a little on the not transparent. I mean, it's still black, but it's not like super duper, eyelinery. Anyway, overall, I would recommend this product to whoever is starting out with makeup. If you haven't used a gel eyeliner before, this is probably a good one to start with because it'll be more forgiving in terms of correcting it. Like I said, this one, it's sort of like one line and it's on and it's thick and it's black and it's staying on there. So yeah, if you're just starting out, I would try this one. I would say that the brush would be fine as well to use for first timers. Just be aware of the fact that it's going to sheer out the product and you might need to put a couple of layers on to get the desired effect. This would be a good one. I'll keep it in my collection. I'm not gonna throw it away or return it or give it to anybody else. I will keep this as a backup, I think, but I will also be repurchasing the MAC one because it's just kind of more practical for my life. I've been using gel liner eyeliner for years, so I don't really have the need for a more forgiving formula, I don't think. I mean, everybody screws up their eyeliner. Liquid, pencil, gel, everyone screws it up every now and then because that's just the nature of the beast, but that's also part of the fun of makeup. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I enjoyed playing around with this, and I really do like trying out new things that I've found on YouTube or through blogs that aren't necessarily, the common or popular or most used product within, like my social circle. Because you often do that with your girlfriends. You'll recommend products to each other, or through the power of advertising, everyone ends up with the same thing. So I like to get a different perspective. If you guys have any other products that you'd like me to try and do a review for you, I'd be more than happy to do. Also, I'll keep you updated on this as it goes with time. It might be the same as with mascara. Mascara after a couple of weeks of being open kind of dries out a little bit, has a little bit more tackiness to it, so it kind of applies a little easier and a little better. So if that happens with this, I'll let you know. But yeah, so this is the Maybelline New York Eye Studio Gel Eyeliner. There you go. Hope you have a good day, guys, and see you next time. Bye!